Hey guys, it's Danielle. In this tutorial series, we'll go through the process of creating and animating a character we want to face and move in multiple directions. I got some time-saving tips I'm sure you'll find useful, so let's dig in. In this part, we will create our character in Photoshop, facing all the different directions, and organize our file for easy export to Spine. There is one trick you can use to reduce the number of animations you have to make, which is to mirror the right animation to get the left one. It works best with symmetric characters, as implying this shortcut on unsymmetric characters tends to break the illusion. To make things easier, let's stick with creating a symmetric character. We start by creating our base directions, down, up, and right. Be sure to place the body parts in different layers during the drawing process. It will save us time and effort for creating the other directions. We can duplicate and mirror both legs and arms in Spine. So I only created one leg, one foot, one arm, one hand, and four fingers for all the eight directions. Once we got the down direction, we can duplicate it to create the up direction. The face parts we can either delete or place under the head layer. We only need minor edits, and we got the up direction. To create the right direction, we need to work a little, but we got parts we can reuse, like the ears and the body, which in this case is round and doesn't change much. We got three directions, only two to go. For creating the 45 degrees, we can shift the shapes of the existing parts of the up and down directions. With some adjustments, we can get a satisfying result. Now that we finish creating all the five directions, we can arrange the PSD file. As I mentioned in previous tutorials, I'm using the PhotoshopToSpine script to export the PSD to Spine. As always, link in the description below. We communicate our attentions for the script by using tags. A tag is a keyword at the beginning of a name of a layer or a folder, surrounded by square brackets. We will give the root folders the tag of folder and the name of its direction. When exporting to Spine, the tag will place all the layers under the folder in a subfolder. Inside each root folder, we will place all body parts under a folder, tagged with a slot tag and the name of a body part. When exporting, this tag will put the layers as attachments under slots in our Spine projects. Under the slot folder, we place a single layer without. Its name will contain the relevant direction and the name of the slot folder it's placed under. If we need multiple layers, we can create a wrapping folder for them, prefixed by the merge tag, that will be merged into a single attachment after export. All folders and layers must have the same names. This is crucial to get an accurate Spine file after exporting. After exporting, we will have different slots in our Spine project, each filled with the relevant attachments of all five directions. One last thing. After we export the PSD, we will want the character to be above the horizontal guideline in Spine. This is important for walkable characters, as the horizontal guideline represents the ground. This way, we can be sure the character won't walk in the air, or its legs won't get cut by the ground. To control the root pivot of the character within the Photoshop file, we click on the ruler corner, and while holding the mouse down, drag the cursor to the position of your choice. If you can't see the rulers, Ctrl R in Windows or Command R in Mac will show and hide them. Now we have the PSD file ready to export. A link to this specific Photoshop file is available to download in the description. Feel free to check it out and export the folders hierarchy by yourself. So that's the end of the first part of the 8 direction tutorial series. In the next part, we will export the character to Spine and start setting it up. Be sure to like and subscribe so you won't miss the next part of the tutorial. We also have other game dev tutorials about Spine and Unity. And we share our own games dev log, so you can see how we use Spine animation in our own game dev process. See you in the next part.